This is Richmond Hill. This is the community that put up a... This is a reef. This is what was not, I say again, was not in front of State Senator Huntley's home. Today is June 11, 2011. This is the fax confirmation sheet that I sent from a business to Southeast Queens Press to Brian Rafferty, the editor. It's a pretty long letter, and I sent them the evidence of the congressman's office filing a false death threat against me to cover things up. Here is more evidence of police abuse referred to chief of departments, but they don't want to do anything, and according to Brian Rafferty, that means there wasn't nothing. That's not true. I've been blue penciled. And this is the letter that shows that the publishing company says, we want your book. But I was on the run due to the congressman's office false police report to police. Okay? I sent them a copy of the Hangman's News, which I told them in the letter. It's going to the president, the vice president, and the first lady. And this is the affidavit behind it and the story of the initial retaliation scheme. No, the second newspaper article about the retaliation scheme against me. Thank you very much. Okay? All I'm trying to tell you people is that New York State Senator Huntley's office has a very close relationship with that newspaper, who doesn't criticize her at all, don't put the real truth out. What they do is they got a newspaper in their pocket. The other newspaper that's in the pocket of New York State Senator Huntley, Malcolm Smith, Councilman Comey, and Congressman Meeks, is the New York Page newspaper with Tom Crater. He's the one that wrote the story, Show Me the Homeless. And now, here it is, June 11, 2011. We know the New York Times put in there hundreds and hundreds and thousands and tens of thousands of homeless people. Tom Crater, that's election fraud. New York State Senator, that's election fraud. Southeast Queens Press, Brian Rafferty and Dominic Rafferty, that's election fraud. That's election fraud. You all need to cut that out. Bye. Okay, we're going to call Sergeant Garcia.
Oh, I think I know him.
Yeah?
He's a Marine guy, right?
I don't know. Yes, man. Speak to Sergeant Garcia.
He's not in the office right now.
He's not in the office?
No.
All right. This is Philip Dreis. He had been calling me and stuff. And I just want to let you guys know, I don't care what the congressman's office might have told you. I ain't no threat to nobody. Y'all sent a whole bunch of detectives all around the neighborhood, slandered my name. And I'm an ABA certified paralegal. I'm a forensic paralegal. And I ain't no threat to nobody. He might want to see that if he goes on the internet and take a look at the shows. Because whatever they...
I don't think he's looking for you in that respect. I think that, you know, what tends to happen is sometimes you have individuals who may be concerned or whatnot, and then they call us, and it's our job to make an assessment of the situation. I think if they were seriously... considering looking for you, they would have definitely went out there aggressively and filed you. I think
y'all would have got me already because I ain't turned off my phone.
I think what they have to do is they have to make contact with you, you know, so they can say that, hey, listen, we spoke to him in person and you know, he's fine. You know,
he scared the crap out of me, man. Detectives was looking for me. People been telling me
all kinds of stuff. So, look, I just want you to know I ain't no threat to the congressman at all. I even videotaped myself going by his office saying, hey, look, I ain't no threat to nobody. I exposed things about crookedness. I've lost, my business lost $5 million. And these people did so much dirt to me, man. Y'all want to look at that? And if they filed a false police report, that's a misdemeanor. They got to get arrested. That's what I'm trying to say. Okay. All right, brother.
All right, hey, listen, you be safe out there, man. Enjoy the beautiful weather today.
Thank you, my friend. You too.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye.
Well, it just looks like we got what we wanted on the internet. Richard Brown, District Attorney. Listen to this. Listen to this. Good. This is the second case I had referred to the Department of Investigations about a cop. But this one's a little bit more important. You know why? That's because the congressman orchestrated his own death threat, filed a false police report, and you better put somebody in jail for that misdemeanor. Now, listen to this crap this guy's about to tell me when he was hunting me and spent tens of thousands of dollars of man-hour time of detectives looking for me, and I'm right here in front of you, right here. I've been right here. I'll tell everybody about it later. Come on, ain't that your picture right there, Mr. Brown? Come on now. Come on now, Mr. Brown. The only reason why I'm not going to put you in the litigation, New York State Supreme Court, is because of ADA Mohammed A-Class and ADA Vanessa Olivia. And I kind of like a young lady that works for you. That's the only reason why. Other than that, I take you to court and let the evidence speak for itself. Your guy, Bernie Porter, and ADA Khadijah Mohammed Starling, those two are a bunch of idiots that messed up the case with Ronnie Green, and your guy, Bernie Porter, threatened me through a newspaper reporter, editor, and publisher of Mr. Tom Crady. Now listen to what your guy got to say about y'all hunting me, trying to get me and make me out to be a death threat against a congressman when it is all a lie, a lie. It is a lie. It is a lie. It is a lie. Let's listen to the cover-up. Yes, may I speak to Sergeant Garcia?
He's not in the office right now.
He's not in the office?
No.
All right, this is Philip Dreis. He had been calling me and stuff. And I just want to let you guys know, I don't care what the congressman's office might have told you. I ain't no threat to nobody. Y'all sent a whole bunch of detectives all around the neighborhood, slandered my name. And I'm an ABA-certified paralegal. I'm a forensic paralegal. And I ain't no threat to nobody. He might want to see that if he goes on the internet and take a look at the shows. Because whatever they...
I don't think he's looking for you in that respect. I think that, you know, what tends to happen is sometimes you have individuals who may be concerned or whatnot, and then they call us, and it's our job to make an assessment of the situation. I think if they were seriously... considering looking for you, they would have definitely went out there aggressively and filed you. I think
y'all would have got me already because I ain't turned off my phone.
I think what they have to do is, they have to make contact with you, you know, so they can say that, hey, listen, we spoke to him in person, and, you know, he's fine. You know,
he scared the crap out of me, man. The detectives was looking for me. People been telling me all kinds of stuff. So, look, I just want you to know I ain't no threat to the congressman at all. I even videotaped myself going by his office saying, hey, look, I ain't no threat to nobody. I exposed things about crookedness. I've lost, my business lost $5 million. And these people did so much dirt to me, man. Y'all want to look at that. And if they filed a false police report, that's a misdemeanor. They got to get arrested. That's what I'm trying to show. Okay. All right, brother.
All right, hey, listen, you be safe out there, man. Enjoy the beautiful weather today.
Thank you, my friend. You too.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye. Well, it just looks like we got what we wanted on the internet.